Okay, so I want to do a painting with a heart, and I'm going to break this up into different sections so that you can create these fun little designs. So I'm going to start. So remember, when we talk about doing our design, we are working with odd numbers. Let's keep up with the odd number idea when we're designing artwork. So I'm going to make a big heart. Try to make it as big as possible. If you end up making it not that big, you can add more. That's the thing. My goal is to have my heart go from here to here and kind of go like this. So when you're drawing your heart, you might want to draw in the air before you do it. If it's not perfect, no erasing. Don't try to change it. I will not change it. You will not change it. I know that feels uncomfortable, but I'm gonna start with the center and I'm gonna curve that way. I know you guys think, oh, she did such a good job. And then I'm gonna do the same thing there. Do you notice that this is not the same as that side? I'm okay with that. So I'm going to do a little fun thing where I'm kind of take that line and continue it just to play around with it. And then I am going to go like that. All I'm doing is breaking up my picture so that I have these little areas that I'm going to paint in different colors. So now I'm going to put some hearts in. I'm going to put a little heart here. I'm going to put a heart that goes like this. Remember, I talked about odd numbers. So, and if can you can make it go right off the page. It does not have to be perfect. Let's count them. One, two, three, four, five. I got five. I feel like I need to have one over here. Maybe. So I have a, yeah, maybe I could do two little ones. There's a little one. This little one. Make it a little tinier. Okay, odd numbers. That's what we want. Okay, so I picked up some paints. Did some water. Now, again, if you want to, you could do this in watercolor. But I'm going to do it in the tempera paint since we just got those. And I am going to choose one of my larger paint brushes to paint with, and it's okay if things change out. And even if I have a different brush than you do, it's okay. So the first thing I'm going to do is do all my reds. I think I'm going to do all my reds where I'm going to have reds and pinks and stuff like that. So I'm going to go straight to the red and paint these different areas. Now I'm going to come back and paint. Whoops, that's okay. I'm going to paint my other areas. That'll give me a little idea. I'm just thinking about that little spot. I'm going to come back and paint my pencil lines with a black paint. So even if the hearts and stuff don't look right, it's okay. So this is going to be pure red. I'm not going to change it. Now that something like this, if you don't change the color, you can just paint right out of the container that I gave you. Okay, so let's find another red area. I like to go opposite so to bring my eyes to different parts of the page. So I'm going to do this side. If you feel like you are not going to be very good at keeping to the edge and not keeping your tables clean, I would put a piece of paper down, but it's up to you. I also have water. Notice I have not touched my water yet. My water state is pretty good. All right, so I'm just holding up and putting a little bit there. Down, it's gonna come right off the page. Oop, went off the paper. So this is washable. You can wash it off your paper. You can wash it off your table. Okay, so I got one more green. So I went, let's go this way. So you're basically drawing your eye. So you use your, you're gonna use your paint to draw your eyes. So what I'm doing is just making sure everybody's paying attention to different parts of the picture. Okay, I wanna do a pink now. So I'm gonna take my red and my, I'm gonna take a little bit of my white and mix it with my red and find areas that I wanna do pink. I think I'm gonna do pink right here since that had a little red in there. So I'm just gonna take my paint, and because it's got different values of red and white, it's gonna make that heart look a little interesting. So I'm just kind of painting it. If it picks up a little red from outside, it doesn't matter. Okay, that looks kind of nice. I'm gonna take a little bit of a, I'm gonna do a little white swirl, make it look a little bit of white right there. Okay, so let's find another pinkish spot. I'm gonna do, maybe make it more pink. Do it right here. As you get more comfortable with your paintbrush, you can probably start experimenting with the way you hold it. But you have to actually paint to actually experiment. Sort of like learning how to ride a bike. The first time you ride your bike, you fall off a lot. And you have to get up and brush yourself off and go on and do some other stuff. But in reality, you got to get up. I'm gonna do a little thing where I'm gonna, okay, we've got two hearts that are pink. Now I'm gonna use that pink for other things. So I'm going to add some pink right here. It needs more water, more of the white. So it's more white, and I want it to kind of move into kind of like an orangey color. Maybe a little bit right here. So I'm gonna take my red, pull it over here, and take my yellow and pull it over here. I'm gonna make one, and then I'm gonna touch it and make it a little bit lighter. Now I'm gonna paint this area. Needs more water. I keep saying water, it's white. So I'm gonna keep up with that. And I'm letting it kind of bleed into my pink over here. So you wanna do this fairly quickly so that the two will kind of bleed into each other. I do need some more white. I think it needs more white. There we go. Is there another wire area that we can do that has this kind of color in it? I think we do. I'm gonna do it right over here. Now see this little swirl? I'm just gonna paint right on it because I can see it through my paints. You probably can't, but I do. Keep adding white as I move away, and just keep adding white as I move away. So it gets more and more of this pinkish color. It's got a little bit of a orangey tinge to it. This kind of looks peachy. So maybe I'm gonna add a little bit more of that in there. Make that come in there a little bit more. You do not have to match my color choices. I do think that you should find colors that will draw your eyes across the picture. So that's why I used red. Everybody looks at red and pays attention to red. It's one of those colors. Think about when somebody comes to school wearing a red shirt, things like that. Red is a powerful color. Okay, so that area has been painted. Now, I do kind of want to do the yellow area a little bit. I want to create, let me see, oh, you know what? I want to make more orange, but I want it to be more yellowy orange. So let me just mix that real quick and put that right here. I wanted to have another orange. So notice that when I'm painting, I try to skip around the paper and try to, because if I skip around when I'm painting, then the eye, the person who's looking at it, will skip around and look at it too. There we go. All right, let me go wash my brush out. Kind of want to change up my colors a little bit. Let's go toward the cool colors for a little bit. I've been working with the warm ones, so now I'm going to do some cool colors. So I'm going to take and move some green and just put white and green together. And I do want it to be more yellowy green, so I'm going to put there. Let's try that. See what we get out of this. Ooh, that's pretty. Don't want to paint my computer. Let's look for another way to paint it. Let's do over here. Let's do this one. And at any time, I can always add a little bit of white to things just to get it to lighten up. And you can still put it on there while it's still wet. It'll create a little new texture. And I kind of want some, do I want to do another green somewhere? Let's look at these. Let's do this one right here. I got a little bit of that pink in there. Don't worry. Just don't mix it. Let it be there. Now, I'm going to do a trick. I'm going to just put that. I'm going to paint the whole area. Ooh, that's kind of cool with that little string. So, I'm going to come back and paint on top of the green once it's dry. So that's one of the last things I'm going to do. All right, let's do another cool color. Let's work with the blue and the white. So when you wash your brush, you probably want to check to see if it's cleaned up. You'll see that I still had a little bit of red left on it, and there's always a chance you can just change out your brush. If you feel like your brush is just not getting clean enough for you at this point. So I'm going to switch out just to show you you can do that. And I am going to notice the way my white is. It is not getting mixed up. I still can touch it at any time. All right, I'm going to just paint that. Now, the Dick Blick blue tends to look almost purplish when it is mixed with white. So it is very cool when you look at it. Oop, there's a little green in that brush. That's okay. I'm just gonna move that over. Maybe make this a little darker around this edge. Now, I can always go back and paint with the warmer colors. Don't think I'm done with them. I'm just, right now, I'm experimenting with color combinations. Like I said, you do not have to have it look exactly like mine. And so I do recommend that you try to blend some of your colors in just because of the way the nature of this project is, where we have all these little colors that kind of blend into each other. So that looks kind of cool. If you can see that, I'm gonna move that so you can see the colors because it's a little glary. There we go. All right, so let us see about another spot. Did that. Let's make this purplish. Let's take some let's take some red, scoop it up, move it over here. It's all right if my brush has a little blue and white on it, because we're just making a purple. So let's see what that does. Ooh, that's really dark. Let's see what that does. Let's move it like that. It's a really dark color. So that means we have to kind of counteract it a little bit. When you have something that draws your eye a lot, like a darker color, you want to counter look at it. So you want to make sure that people look to another spot. They don't just sit there and look at that. I know it doesn't, you don't think that that's what happens, but some artists, when they go look at other people's artwork, will examine how things are being done, and they'll notice that they are being forced to look at different parts of the picture, and they'll use color as a way to get your eyes to move in a different direction. So I'm going to put a little bit of red in there, put that kind of mix in there, take a little bit of blue, mix over here. So we've got that. So let's do that over here. Some red and some blue together, and just mix it. If I put too much wine in it, it starts to look more lavendery. And we've got a lot of pastel colors. We use the word pastel when we think of colors that have added white to them, when in reality, a pastel is like a little crayon that has these colors, and it's just the way we add color. Okay, excuse you. Eyes holes. Poop, poop. So we started with red, and then we did some orange and green. So notice I'm kind of following with the idea of the different colors. Okay, let's we go. Okay, so I'm going to do a little thing where you take and do a quick brush stroke, and that brush stroke just creates like a little highlight. And so I'm just going to take my brush, load it with white. I don't have any other colors on it, and kind of like where different things are, I'm going to create like a little like that. And I'm just going to do little dashes, and these little dashes are like these, they're fake highlights. Oh, that brush had a little bit of something in there. Let me get that cleaned up. And so I'm going all the way around and just adding little things. And I have to add something right here. Remember, I forgot about that one. And then I'm gonna go just doing a quick line, just because I can. And you don't have to do this, but it's something you can try as a way. Always go back and clean up your brush in case you drag in something else. Right there. And right here. Here. And I kind of want to make it look like it's got highlights on the piece itself. Okay, now I have to do something right there. So let's see what I'm going to put here. Let us do a little bit of a purple. Let's do a little purple on that one. And just... make that heart. Might be too small for the black line, but just kind of trying to... There we go. I'm not gonna spend too much time on that. So right now, I have all my little sections. All my little sections have been painted. So I just kind of want to let it dry a little bit, and then I'm gonna come back and paint with the... All right, okay, I'm back. Most of it's dry. There's a few spots here and there that are wet, but that's okay. But before I go and paint my black lines, I want to practice. So I'm going to go ahead and pick up the brush that we use for watercolors and just play around with the brush and practice it. So let's see. Can I do a straight line? Yeah, pretty good. So what I'm doing is I'm just practicing. So let's do this again. This time I'm going to go a little bit faster. That worked. The next thing I'm going to do is do a letter. Okay. So I'm going to go like this. Oh, so now I need to go back and just kind of like load my brush like that. I do another one where I do... I'm changing my mind about how I do my... I'd rather have my heart be okay than to sit there and redo it. Now, I just went back a little bit on this line because it's not as thick as the other ones. So that's a practice that you might want to do. I'm not pressing hard. I'm pressing enough. So notice that didn't do too well, so I didn't load up well enough. And I'm going to go like that. I'm going to go like that. And try to get them so that they're even. But I'm not going to go and go, woof, 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 these little lines. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing that. I'm creating a line. And if it doesn't work, I come back and change the angle of my brush. Okay. I'm going to let that dry and I'll come back and paint that. All right, so let's try this out. Let's try it out. Let us try it out. Let's try it on a heart. This one has a little bit of red in it, so I'm gonna not make sure my brush is going into the red. I'm gonna move this out of the way so I don't run into it. So my brush is not in. Now you'll notice like I put my finger on a little bit of black, and so there's that. So we're gonna have to work with that. I may come back and play around with that idea. Now I'm just there we go. So how did that turn out for you guys? Did you like it? Okay, so just cleaning up some lines that I wanted to have more sharp. That's all I'm doing. I'm not really changing it. I wanted my tips to be pointy, so I'm making my tips of my hearts a little bit more pointy. Okay, I think we're done. I would make sure that you write your initials. So my initials are SJS, so I'm gonna do I do a kind of a cursive J, and then I do a cursive S. This is something I started doing in the last couple of years for my initials. So that's an SJS. Now, I'm going to do one last thing, and that is to clean my brush. When you get down, you clean your brushes. And I'm going to add some little funky little things that they did. I saw this was being done on a picture. And you put little dots around the curve. So I'm going to touch my white. Touch my white, make sure it's pointy, and then I'm going to do dot, dot, dot. I make up big, little, and smaller. And I do that. I don't swirl because then I might mix on the black. Okay, so that's it. All done.